Clamp the rebound damper shaft in the Reverb Vise Block's 10mm slot, just tight enough to hold it secure. Clean the rebound damper shaft so it does not spin. To prevent permanent damage to the rebound damper shaft, clamp the shaft nearest to the piston stud. Unthread and remove the rebound piston nut. Insert a pick onto the center of the rebound damper piston stud. Slide the complete rebound piston assembly, all parts, onto the pick, and remove it from the rebound damper piston stud. Remove the first check shim and the check shim spacer. These parts will not be reinstalled. Install the Charger 3.1 rebound damper check spring onto the rebound damper piston stud. Install the rebound damper piston assembly back onto the rebound damper piston stud, on top of the Charger 3.1 rebound check spring. Press the piston down and compress the check spring to confirm the check shim and piston are completely seated onto the rebound damper piston stud. Adjust the shim as needed. If the check shim and rebound damper piston are not correctly seated onto the rebound damper piston stud, the check shim can be permanently damaged when the piston nut is tightened. Hold the piston assembly down and install the rebound piston nut onto the rebound damper piston stud. Tighten it to the specified torque. To avoid damage to the rebound damper, do not over-tighten the piston nut. Apply grease to the new inner and outer IFP O-rings and install them onto the IFP. Apply a thin coat of suspension oil to the inner surface of the IFP tube. Insert the IFP into the IFP tube, flat end, outer O-ring first, into the outer threaded end of the IFP tube. Press the IFP into the IFP tube until it is approximately 30mm from the end of the opposite end of the tube. Apply a light coat of suspension oil to the high-speed compression piston assembly shaft. From the hex end of the IFP tube, insert the high-speed compression piston assembly into and through the center of the IFP. Press it into the IFP until the piston assembly is approximately 20mm above the internally threaded end of the IFP tube. Apply suspension oil to the low-speed compression piston assembly shaft and O-rings. Hold the piston to keep it from moving. From the external threaded end of the IFP tube, insert the low-speed compression shaft assembly, gold narrow end first, into the high-speed compression piston assembly shaft. Push the low-speed compression piston assembly until the narrow gold shaft end protrudes through the piston bolt until it stops and snaps into place completely seated. Rotate the low-speed compression shaft and align the bolt hole in the high-speed compression assembly with the adjustment groove stop in the low-speed compression shaft assembly. Install both cam set screws evenly, finger tight. Tighten each to the specified torque. Pull the piston up until it is above the end of the IFP tube. Clamp the high-speed compression assembly into the vise at the cam hex wrench flats. The piston should be above the vise blocks and the IFP tube should be below the vise blocks. Do not clamp on the set screws. Install the compression nut onto the inner low-speed compression rod end and tighten it. The low-speed compression adjuster will rotate when the nut is tightened. Rotate it counterclockwise, back to full extension after the nut is tightened. Using a non-metallic pick, push the IFP evenly into the IFP tube until the hollow end is just below the IFP tube bleed porthole. The IFP should not cover the bleed porthole. Push the piston down until it is approximately 5mm above the end of the IFP tube. Inject suspension oil into the IFP tube until it is full. Oil will fill the IFP tube above the IFP and below the piston. Hold a shop towel around the IFP tube. Push the piston down and into the IFP tube until it stops. Follow the link below or in the upper right-hand corner for the rest of the Charger 3.1 damper service and assembly procedure. For more information about Charger 3.1 damper upgrade and shim tuning procedures, refer to the 2023 PLUSH, ZEB, Lyrik, and Pike service manual.